Good afternoon, children. Welcome to today's English session. And in today's English session, we shall continue with the poem John Brown by Bob Dylan. In the last session, I had discussed up till 8th stanza. So, in the 8th stanza, we observed, if you remember, that his face was disfigured and his hand was blown, and he was not in a position to talk to his mother, who had come to the station to receive him happily. So today we shall start with the stanza number 9. Don't you remember me, Ma, when I went off to war? You thought it was the best thing I could do. I was on the battleground, you were home acting proud. You wasn't there standing in my shoes. Now what does this stanza explain? This stanza explains, now he is asking his mother to recollect. And he is asking his mother that doesn't she recollect that her son was getting ready to go to war, that is why the second line says, Ma, when I went off to war, don't you remember me, Ma, when I went off to war? That is, he is asking his mother, oh mom, don't you remember that I was off to war. You thought it was the best thing I could do, and he says to her, oh mother, you always felt proud of me in my uniform, and you told all your neighbors that I was going for fighting a war. That is why he says in this line, you thought it was the best thing I could do. You here refers to mother. You thought it was the best thing I could do. So he says to his mother, oh mother, that she had thought that it was the best thing for her son to go to war. I was on the battleground, you were home acting proud. Now what is these two lines say? I was on the battleground. So after having gone to the war, here the son says that he was off to the battlefield. He was off to the battlefield while his mother was at home feeling very proud that her son had gone to the battlefield. You wasn't there standing in my shoes. Now what does the son say to mother? You are feeling very proud sitting at home that your son had gone to the battlefield, but you are not realizing what a battlefield looked like. How I felt in the battlefield. That is why the last one says, You wasn't there standing in my shoes. That means son is telling to mother, oh mother, if you were there in my place in the battlefield, you would not have talked so proud about wars, and you would not have talked so proud about your son in the uniform. So what he means to say here is that mother was feeling very proud of her son in uniform going to the battlefield, whereas she was sitting at home and she didn't realize the real situation that was going on in the battlefield. That is what this whole entire stanza states. Now I am coming to stanza number 10. Oh, and I thought when I was there, what am I doing here? Now here, John Brown says, oh, and I thought when I was there. So he is expressing his feelings when he was in the battlefield. He was totally perplexed. He was totally confused. Perplexed means confused. He was confused and he is talking to himself. God, what am I doing here? Means he is witnessing the killings going on in the battlefield. So he is asking to himself, oh God, what am I doing here? That is, now only he is realizing that it is not sufficient to be proud in the uniform, but one really realizes what a war is when a soldier gets into the war. I am not trying to kill somebody or die trying. Now he is asking himself, am I trying to kill somebody or am I trying to kill myself? So now only he realizes that what a battlefield looks like. That is why in the previous line he is saying, God, what am I doing? Satisfied means he is wondering whether he is killing somebody or is he trying to kill himself. Is he trying to kill himself? For what purpose has he come to the battleground in a soldier's uniform? But the thing that scared, the skill thing that scared me most was when my enemy came close and he is expressing his fear. He says he feared the situation when the enemy came near to him. When he faced the enemy, he was totally in fear. He was totally in fear. That's why he says, but the thing that scared me the most, what was the thing that scared me the most? The thing that scared me the most was when my enemy came close. That is, when the enemy came close to him, he was really terrified. He was really terrified. And I saw that his face looked like mine. So, his enemy also was a brother. And he is expressing his brotherly feelings here. He says, his enemy was a human being and he was also a human being. So, how could a human being kill a human being? What is this war? What is the purpose of this war? So, all these sort of thoughts were running into his mind. Then he says, Oh Lord, just like mine. And when he sees the enemy's face, he just thinks that the enemy's face is also like his face. That is what he means to say here, is that he is also human, the enemy is also a human. That is what he means to say by saying, Oh Lord, just like mine. Now I am coming to stanza number 11. And I couldn't help but think through the thunder rolling and sting. Now here I couldn't help but think through. So he was just listening to the sound of the bombs going off in the battlefield. He was listening to the guns blazing and what he says. And I couldn't help but think through the thunder rolling and sting. He was only hearing the sound of the shells bursting out in and around and rolling and sting, and he could feel the smell of the burning bodies nearby him. That is what he means to say. And I couldn't help but think through the thunder rolling and the sting. So thunder rolling here refers to all the sounds created by the bursting of the bombs. And the word sting here refers to the burning smell that comes that is arising out of the dead bodies which were getting burned. That I was just a puppet in a play. Then only he realizes that he was a puppet. He was like a puppet in the play. He was like a puppet in the war. And through the roar and smoke, this string is finally broke. And so he could hear the roaring of the bombs. And he could see the smoke. And while he was observing this, so finally a string breaks and a cannonball blew his eye away. And suddenly he finds a cannonball coming and hitting his eyes, and he has his eyes blown away. So this is stanza 11. Stanza 12. As he turned away to walk, his mouth was still in shock. Now this is the scene that is taking place in the railway station. Now as he turned and he turned away to walk. So he turned away to walk. He was frustrated that his face was disfigured and his hands got blown away. So he got frustrated and he just was about to turn and walk away, and his ma was still in shock. He could see that his mother was still in terrific shock. She was in terrific shock. And seeing the metal brace that helped him stand, so he was wearing a metal brace which was helping him to stand. But as he turned to go, he called his mother close. He called his mother close. And he dropped his medal down into her arms. And he took out all his medals and he dropped it into her arms. So what does this signify, dropping of the medals into her arms? That is, he says, what he signifies by this act is that that war is all useless. War is all useless. And war is all useless. And furthermore, the glorification which he felt by wearing the uniform or wearing the medals was just superfluous. And at the same time, he also tells his mother that all her imagination about a soldier in a uniform and going to a battlefield and winning medals was also superfluous. So ultimately he gives us a conclusion that war was absolutely worthless. Thank you, children. I hope you must have understood all these four stanzas.